Hi, everybody. It's James Girl 37. It's probably dark in here. I don't know what you can see, what you can't, but I had to put my cat to sleep today. And yeah, she had kidney failure, really, really bad. And I mean, she just, I don't know, like a day and a half, she just was severely sick. So I took her. She had that, like, you know, look like she was going to die look. So I took her to the vet. We left, like, 4-something in the morning and waited till, like, 8:30 in the morning for it to open. And we didn't have an appointment, and, you know. But they saw her first before anybody else. And I didn't know how sick she was. I didn't know she had kidney failure. Like, just really nothing they could do for her, and they said that she possibly had cancer on her skin or her nipples or something. So they were saying if we give her treatments, that she's going to need a catheter, maybe a thing down her throat to be able to eat, you know, and she'll have to have a bag for life, like a bag of fluids or antibiotics. We'll have to put it in her bag. And how much is, you know, it just seemed cruel to keep her in that condition, because the bag we had, we was there for like 5 hours, and the bag was like that much gone. So, I'm real hurt. That was my baby. I had her for 13 years. I'm watching her videos on my phone and my camera. I haven't got on the computer to look at it. It really hurts a lot. Yeah.
Hey, that's cool, man.
It hurt a lot. And to watch her die, you know, they gave her the needle.
All right.
I was going to leave the room, but they told me, you know, come here and watch. And I did, and I was going to stay in the corner, and I just started going crazy. I started cursing and stomping and everything. Like, everything else seems so petty, you know. And I know some people probably like, oh, it's just a damn cat, but I had it for 13 years since she was a newborn. And we went from Newark all the way to Hawaii. It just really hurts a lot. I miss her so much. And they were like, you could bury her in a mass grave, or you could cremate her. And I was like, no. So I'm just going to get the stuff she like and bury where, and find somewhere on this island to bury her. We have a place that's kind of nice. That is nice. And, it hurts a lot. Really do. She was like my daughter. And I know some people can't understand that. And some people can. I miss her so much. I just, you know, I told her I love her, I said my goodbyes and everything, and I stayed a while. My husband was there, my son. And I probably put this up when I feel better, you know. I don't think I'll put this up anytime soon. I might not put it up. Maybe I'll put up, you know, when I grieved a little bit, because it's just fresh. It's just weird to be home without her. I mean, she had a lot of personality. A lot. And if anybody, like, talked to me on the phone, know that I talked to her like she was a human being. I yelled at her like she was a human being and talked to her as if she could talk back. Not that I'm crazy, but she understood what I meant. And people just got a kick out of it, but, you know. 13 years. Yeah, I had her since my son was 7. So, it's like losing a family member hurts a lot. So, I don't know if I don't feel like eating or anything. Yeah, and it's just kind of odd me having kidney disease and her dying of kidney failure. It just would have been cruel to keep her and, like, have all those tubes in her. What quality of life would she have, you know? all. Yeah, this was unexpected. I miss her. I pulled out the doll I made of her. I don't know. I think it makes me feel sadder. And there were some videos I was going to delete, and I didn't. I'm glad I didn't delete it. I just keep watching, because it just don't seem like she's really gone. But just see her stuff is painful. I told her I love her. I told her I love her the whole time. We were there for hours. Because I had to decide, but it was like, you know, you get the treatments. I just wanted her to have a good quality of life. She liked to go outside, and, you know, she was a fighter, you know. All the cats were scared of her. So she was a little tough girl, you know, from the bricks, north. And, yeah, from north to Hawaii. Yeah, I thought she'd be me a little bit longer, but they were like 13 years. She was old, but she only had like a few gray hairs that I noticed. But she was okay. She was acting her normal self, and then like 2 days she acted like she couldn't walk. So it's a hard thing to do. And, you know, I don't know if I'll ever get another cat again. I just don't even want to think about it. Well, thanks for watching.